Bakuchi. So the drug we'll discuss. So before going to start the today's drug, so yesterday we have discussed Agnimanta. That is Agnimantati iti Agnimantaha. That when the two dried sticks of Agnimanta, when you rubbed each other, so it will produce the fire. Or it is they are used for one of the important the detailed drug that is specially it is a its utility is mentioned by Acharya Shushruta. Even though Acharya Charaka has mentioned, but it is not mentioned in any of the Mahakashaya. So its utility is mentioned by Acharya Charaka. But mainly he highlighted the Shvitragna property and Kushtagna property of Bakuchi. So in the Shushruta Samhita, Acharya Shushruta, instead of using the term Bakuchi, he mentioned the term Avalguja. So if you search the Samhitas, so you will not get the term Bakuchi. So instead of that, they used to mention the term as Avalguja. So Avalguja is a synonym of Bakuchi. So this is mainly highlighted by Acharya Shushruta. So in the NEET examinations, they may ask, okay? So this is actually the practical utility, specifically about the Svitra, the type of Kushta. So it is mentioned by Acharya Shushruta. So this is the picture. So it is an annual herb. See the erect herb, it is. So regarding Vedakala, so in Vedakala will not found any reference regarding Bakuchi, but that is main Vedic text like Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda and Atharvaveda. They have not mentioned the utility of Bakuchi. But Agni Purana, Garuda Purana, the Puranas, they have mentioned the utility of Bakuchi in the Puranas. Okay. So when coming to the Samhita Kala, so it is identified with the synonym as Avalguja. As already I have mentioned, so instead of Bakuchi, so Bakuchi term is, it is more familiar, becomes in, during the Nigantu period. So in Samhita period, it is well known with the name as Avalguja. Okay, so in the classical text, the preparations like Avalguja di Lepa, Avalguja di Churna, the preparations they have prepared in the name of Avalguja. So the Bakuchi is in Samhita period, it is well known with the name Avalguja. So Bakuchi term is used during the, it is get more important and importance and more familiar during the period of Nigantu period. So it has two important properties, that is Shvitragna and Vishagna. So Shvitragna property is mainly in this case, it is used by, or its utility is highlighted by Acharya Shushruta. So we'll see the basonym of Bakuchi. Bakbihi kuchyate shabdhat, because of its the qualities, that is prashasta gunatvat. It is a reputed drug for its use in Shvitra. Vagbihi kuchyate shabdhate stuyate prashasta gunatvat, because of its the specific character, because of its specific guna, it is mainly used, it is mainly highlighted its the action in case of Shvitra. Okay, that is the basonym of Bakuchi. The botanical source for Bakuchi is Sorolia corollifolia, P-S-O-R-A-L-E-A, Sorolia, P silent, Sorolia corollifolia. Corollifolia, that they used to say is a helmet like a nut like the part which is present over the fruit, they used to say is Sorolia corollifolia and belongs to the family Fabaceae family. So vernacular names Bavachi, Sorolia seed, and Kannadadalli Bavanchi, Bavanchi Kannadadalli, Bavachi, Sorolia seed and Bavanchi Kannadadalli. Okay, next Charaka has not mentioned in any of the Mahakashaya, even Shushruta has not mentioned in any of the Ganas. Okay, so directly we'll move to the synonyms. So based on the leaves, Supernika, Supernika, Shobhanati Parananashyaha, that is the leaves are beautiful, are attractive, Supernika. So based on the fruit, Krishna Phala, how it looks, what is the color of the fruit? That is Krishnam Phalamashyaha, that is Krishna Varanam Phalamashyaha. The fruits are having black in color, that is black colored fruits. Krishnam Phalamashyaha, krishna varanam palamashyah, that is the fruits are black in color. Kalameshi, kalam mishati spardhate krishna phaletyartha, that is kalameshi, the fruits are black in color. Some acharyas, they have mentioned, it is an perennial plant like that, they have mentioned its description, but annual herb, but you can correlate phalamashyah. So it emits, the fruit emits, or actually the fruit is seed predominant. The fruit is seed predominant. The seed covered by somewhat sticky like the material, which emits a bad odor when you touch, when you crush. So at that time, it produces bad odor. Pooti phala, pooti durgandhi phalamashyah. Next, based on the seeds, somaraji. Based on the seeds, somaraji shashileka. So two synonyms, somaraji shashileka. Shashi means Chandra, so Leka, even Indu Leka, Somaraji, Shashi Leka, Indu Leka. So that is Chandra Sheva Reka Asham. Chandra Sheva Reka Asham. The Reka, that is the line or the strike which is present over the seed, which is like Chandra Seva, means white color streak, white color line which is present over the seed. When you open the seed, so you will get, so almost it is black, but in one side you will get a white streak. So that is called, they used to say, Somaraji, Shashileka, and Induleka. So these are the synonyms of Bakuchi. Based the seeds, based on the karma, Shvitragni. So this is the only one drug which is having the dual action according to the modern. So there is actually in the modern about the vitiligo or leucoderma. So there is, the success rate is very less, but the Ayurvedic drugs, especially this Sorolia, it is having the dual action. So this the ail, the thyla, which acts on the rugate cells and the melanoblastic cells. So this type of action will be very less modern. So it is having irritant action. It's an irritant action, irritates the cells, especially the melanin. So melanin is the responsible factor which gives the black color. Where in case of Shvitra or the leucoderma or vitiligo, where there will be white patches. So that is because of the reduced function of the melanin. So this is the only one drug which is having the dual action, that which acts on rugate cells as well as the melanoblastic cells. That is Shvitragni. Shvitram hantiti Shvitragni. One which cures Shvitra. It is a type of Kushta. Okay, so Kushtagni, Kushtam Hanti iti Kushtagnam, the drugs one which cures the Kushta or the skin diseases, that is called as Kushtagni. And Aval Gujam, so this is the classical term used by so most of the acharyas instead of Bakuchi. Avalgu Ashobhanam Ashobhanam Agam Valgu Shobhanam Janayati iti, that is some. Even the international journals, they have published the description of Avalguja as one which is having ugly in nature, they used to say. Means the person, when he suffer with the Kushta, so at that time he is ugly. That is Ashobanam Angam. Ashobanam Angam. By using this drug, Avalguja, Shobhanam Janayati, one which generates, one which gives the complexion. So in that aspect you can take. Even the international journal, they have published that it is having like which ugly in nature, but it is not like that. It is my opinion that you can take when the person is suffering with like the Kushta Vikaras, at that time the person is having ugly in nature. So when you use administer this drug, so which produces Shobhanam Janayati, one which produces the complexion, so by that which overcomes the condition called Kushta. Okay, so these are the some of the synonyms of Bakuchi. So next we'll move to the Swarupa, that is habit. So already I have shown the picture about the Bakuchi, the plant. It is an erect herb. Bakuchi plant, it is an erect herb. So in this slide you can observe about the leaves. Arrangement of leaves you can clearly observe. That is, the arrangement of leaves is alternate. So here is here one leaf is there and here another leaf is there, and so you can observe this is the inflorescence. So this is the main branch and this is the leaf. So the inflorescence is originating from the axillary region. So and the lamina is not dissected. So based on this character, you can say it is a simple leaf. So here clearly you can observe. So this is the main, the stem, the main branch. So from the node, the leaves is going to originate from the axillary region, from the axilla. So the inflorescence they used to develop. So based on this character, you can say this is type of leaf is simple, as the lamina which is not dissected or not divided. Okay, so type of leaf is simple, and arrangement you have seen that is alternate. So you can observe the margin. So it is somewhat dentate margin. The lamina is dissected. The lamina is minutely dissected, show somewhat dentate margins, and you can observe. So this is the small point-like structure. So this type of character we used to say mucronate apex, mucronate phase, where the lamina is abruptly terminating into a small hair-like structure which may contain or may not contain the chlorophyll. But here in this case, you can a green color. So definitely the apex contains the chlorophyll part. So small, a point hair-like structure, the small projections. So for that we used to say mucronate apex. Okay, and so this is the inflorescence. You can observe. So this is the arrangement of the flowers on the main peduncle. So this is called the main peduncle. Over that, the small flowers are arranged in acropetalous section. Means older flowers at the base, younger flower towards the apex. That is the characteristic feature of raceme inflorescence. Okay, so you can say the inflorescence is axillary. So axillary, even the terminal. So axillary raceme inflorescence. The type of inflorescence is axillary raceme inflorescence. So this is what you are observing. Definitely it looks like a seed, but it is not seed. So you can say fruit. As I have already mentioned that the in case of bakuchi, it looks like the seeds are seed predominant. In case of the fruit, seed will be predominant. I will show another pictures. Okay, about the habit. So it is an erect annual herb. Bakuchi, it's an annual. So it completes its life cycle in 1 year. Within 1 year, it completes its life cycle. That is from seed to the seed. Okay, so it is an erect annual herb. So stem will be soft. It is not weak. So stem will be soft in nature. So that's why they used to consider under herb, which grows about 1 to 3 feet height. Which grows about 1 to 3 feet. And the branches are firm and gland dotted. The branches are firm and gland dotted. So because of this gland dotted, so it is somewhat rough. The old stem will be somewhat rough in nature. Next, we'll move to the leaves. So type of leaf is, already have shown the pictures. That is simple leaf. Arrangement of the leaf is alternate, and shape is somewhat round or heart shaped. Even you can say broadly elliptic in nature. Round or heart shaped, or even broadly elliptic in shape. And the size of the lamina is around about 4 to 8 centimeter in length. The size of the lamina is around about 4 to 8 centimeter and 2.5 to 5 centimeter broad. 2.5 to 5 centimeter broad, and apex is mucronate. So this is specific character. You can observe the apex, mucronate apex, and the margin is rupend or toothed. Instead of rupend, you can mention toothed or the dentate margin. The margins of the lamina is dissected, so that's why you can say the margin is toothed or dentate. Surface is glabrous, especially the upper surface is glabrous in nature. So this is about the leaf. Next, we'll move to the inflorescence and the fruits. So you can observe the inflorescence. Here the flowers are developed. So this is a type of raceme inflorescence, where it is a cluster of flowers which is arranged in the main peduncle. So in this picture, you can clearly observe the color of the flowers. So this is another picture which shows about the inflorescence. So here you can observe about the fruits. So if you keenly observe, there will be a small, the persistent calyx will be present, dark colored. It is Krishna phala, kalameshika. Krishna phala, kalameshika. The fruits are black in color and with a persistent calyx. Persistent calyx. The calyx like it is like a papery material which holds the fruits. Which holds the fruits. So here you can, in this picture, you can clearly observe. So this is the persistent calyx, which is somewhat very thin, like papery like material, which is covered over the fruits. That is persistent calyx, and fruits are black in color. So when the fruits are fresh, if you squeeze that the fruit, so you will get a sticky nature will be present. That is, if you if you rub the fruit, the wax like or sticky materials will come out, and the only remaining thing will be the seed. That is bija pradhana phala. So this is the fruit. So these are the seeds, as you can observe, seeds of bakuchi. So this is another picture which shows about bakuchi. So here clearly you can observe. So see, the persistent calyx will be present. So this persistent calyx, if it is present, then you can say it is fruit. It is fruit. Bija pradhana. So the inflorescence axillary. From the axilla, the inflorescence they used to develop. Okay. So 10 to 30 flowered. So 10 to 30 flowers they used in cluster form. And it is, the nature is racemose. That I have mentioned, that is acropetalous section. That is older flowers at the base, younger flowers towards the apex. So that is a 10 to 30 flowers. That is the older flowers at the base, younger flowers towards the apex. So in this manner, the flowers are arranged. So that's why they used to consider as racemose, axillary, 10 to 30 flower, racemose inflorescence. And the flowers are bluish purple in color. Bluish purple in color. They are attached to the long peduncle, and short pedicels will be present. The flowers, the peduncle will be long, but the pedicel, the stalk of the flower is short, the short pedicels. So that's why the 10 to 30 flowers are, they used to attach to the main peduncle. That is around about, this is about the inflorescence. Next we'll move to the fruit. Type of fruit is pod. The nature of the fruit, as it belongs to the Fabaceae family. So definitely the type is pod. Size of the fruit is 5 millimeter. So this is very important, very small fruit. That is seed predominant. Size of the fruit is 5 millimeter in length, and color is blackish. That is Krishna phala, kalameshika. Color of the fruit is black color. Shape, ovoid or somewhat kidney shaped. Ovoid or somewhat kidney shaped the fruits, and compressed. The fruit is compressed, closely pitted in one seeded indehiscent. The fruit is indehiscent in nature. The fruits are indehiscent in nature. That is seed predominant. Seeds are smooth, small, adhering to the pericarp. As I have mentioned, the seeds are, it is more predominant, which is adhered to the pericarp. So pericarp, if you remove, if you rub, the pericarp will go, only you will get the seed. Okay. So next, Utpatti Sthana. It is common in Bihar, Punjab, Rajasthan, Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Assam. So in these areas, especially in the drier parts of India, so it is very common. Common in Bihar, Punjab, Rajasthan, Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, and Assam, where the rainfall is less. So in that particular place, so it is very commonly available. Next, we'll move to the types of bakuchi. So this is specially mentioned by Acharya Sushruta. So even Charaka has not mentioned about the types, and Nigantukaras are also very less about, as the Sushruta mainly highlighted the utility of bakuchi. So that's why he mentioned two types of bakuchi. That is Shweta Avalguja, Krishna Avalguja. See, already I have mentioned, Sushruta has not used the term bakuchi. So instead of that bakuchi, he used the term Avalguja. So based on the color of the fruit, that is Shweta Balguja, Krishna Balguja. Already have seen the fruits of Bakuchi, that is, which is having Krishna Phala or Krishna Varana Phala, that is Kalameshika, which is having black in color. But so this Bakuchi here, Shweta Abalguja, he used to mention, which is having white color, and that is specifically he mentioned the utility of Shweta Abalguja for Medhya Karma, one which enhances the intellectuality. So for that he highlighted Shweta Abalguja, whereas Krishna Abalguja, he mainly highlighted its utility in case of Shvetra and Kushta. Okay, Shweta Abalguja, Krishna Abalguja, Shweta Abalguja, the utilities mentioned for its in case of Medhya Karma, and Krishna Abalguja, that is specifically for Shvetra Karma or the Kushtagna Karmas. So these are the some of the important active principles of Bakuchi. So please remember the active principles of Bakuchi. So many times they've asked in the examinations, the short questions, short answers. That is main active principle, as the thaila is predominant in this, the Bakuchi. So we used to prepare, we used to extract the thaila, that is extract of thaila. So essential oil, it contains swaralin, the main active principle, which is present in Bakuchi. Swaralin, isoswaralin, swaralin, isoswaralin, corallifolin, soralidin. And fixed oil, Bakuchiol, active principle. So especially this soralin, isoswaralin, Bakuchiol, so they used its mainly in case of Leucoderma or in case of vitiligo. So as it contains the some of the active principle, irritant action on the particularly over the skin cells, so by that which helpful in curing the vitiligo, the conditions or Shvetra conditions. So these are the chemical structures of the active principles of Bakuchi: soralin, talin, corallin, soralidin. So these are the some of the important active principles, chemical structure. So if you know the chemical structure, so even you can artificially, you can prepare the preparations or the medicines, you can prepare artificial preparations also, you can prepare if you know the chemical structure. So next we'll move to the rasapanchaka, that is the pharmacodynamics. So mainly it is having the tikta madhura rasa. Some nigantakaras, they have mentioned even katurasa, tikta katurasa, tikta madhura rasa. Even the Shushruta, Charaka, they have highlighted that is, they used to mention Bakuchi under tikta skanda, katuka skanda, they used to mention. And the gunas of Bakuchi is having the lagu, ruksha and saraguna. Lagu, ruksha and saraguna, katu vipaka, shita virya. So regarding the virya, there is a difference of opinion among the acharyas, especially the Rajanigantukara, there is Pandit Narahari, he used to say the Bakuchi is having ushna virya. Bakuchi is having ushna virya, and some the Bhava Prakasha, he used to say like shita virya. But there is a difference. Even some acharya says it is anushna shita virya, anushna shita virya, or anushna virya, nati shita nati ushna, that is anushna, ati shita or ati ushna. So there is like in the middle it will comes anushna. So Bhava Prakasha, they used to mention about shita virya, but Rajanigantukara, he mentioned as ushna virya. So dosha karmagata is kafavata shamaka. So if you see the according to Bhava Prakasha Nigantu, so it is almost samana pratyarabdha as tiktrasa is pradhana. So tiktrasa having the predominance of vayu akasha tiktraha, vayu and akasha mahabhuta predominance is there. So because of vayu mahabhuta, lagu and ruksha guna is there, lagu and ruksha guna. Because of akasha, that is even the almost all lagu ruksha shita guna, that is like vata gunas. So vata gunas. So even katuvipaka, usually tiktrasatmaka dravyas are undergoing katuvipaka, and usually tiktrasatmaka dravyas are undergoing shita virya. So this is according to see the, if you see the pradhana rasa, that is according to that it is samana pratyarabha dravya. Okay, so tiktrasa lagu ruksha shita guna, lagu ruksha sara guna, kata vipaka shita virya, and kapha vata shyamaka. Next we'll move to the karma and rogagnata. So this sorolia, corolifolia or babachi for skin disorders. So good in vitiligo, that is in case of svitra or leucoderma, the white spots improves the immune system and helps in detoxification. The karma and rogagnata of bakuchi is having kushtagna, svitragna. If you want, you can write mainly svitra. First, the choice, if they ask regarding amayika prayoga or karma of bakuchi or avalbuja, first choice should be svitragna karma, svitragna kushtagna. So you can write the svitragna and kushtagna karma. So that's why it is indicated in case of kushta, and svitra is having tvachya and varna karma. So definitely it is indicating case of tvak and varna vikruti. It is having swasahara karma. So indicating case of swasa, it is having mehahara, that is pramehahara karma. So indicating case of prameha, it is having kandugna karma. So indicating case of kandu. In case of it is having krimigna karma. So indicating case of krimi, it is having kasahara karma. So indicating case of kasa. And it is having shothahara karma, so indicating case of shotha. So why the bakuchi or avalbuja is best or sreshta in case of svitra or vitiligo? So what may be the reason? So this is I have taken from the international journals. So bakuchi is the only drug that has a dual action, that is usually the drug action we used to say is the drug action is because maybe stimulation, maybe depression, maybe irritation, or maybe the replay.